Ready, steady, wait. It's been 47 days since our lives were locked down. Level 3 wasn't leagues different, and we won't get level 2 in one fell swoop.
We may have won a few battles, but we have not won the war.
So these are the next front lines, the stages of level 2 starting midnight Wednesday. When you wake up Thursday, shops, malls, cafes, restaurants, cinemas, playgrounds and gyms will open. On Monday the 18th, back to school. And on Thursday the 21st of May, bars can finally reopen.
Essentially means if the primary purpose is for dining, you can open. If the primary purpose is for drinking, then there's that delay. That does mean pubs who provide meals and so on will be able to open.
It just basically means less income, higher expenses. Essentially, some businesses won't make it.
The Prime Minister says bars pose the greatest risk, pointing to a recent spike of 50 cases in South Korea after one man went to 5 nightclubs.
We don't want to be South Korea. Open our bars only to close them again.
Mass gatherings have been ruled too risky. You can burst your bubble for friends and family, but 10 is the magic number. It's easier to trace.
Gatherings at home need to be kept at 10. Church and religious events, weddings, funerals, stag do's, all limited to 10 for now.
Domestic travel is back on, but don't go wild.
So go and see your mum. Just don't turn it into a massive family reunion while you're at it.
After the Prime Minister announced the details of Level 2 last week, it got some raring to go.
I think the majority of the population has had enough and is ready to just get back out again.
I certainly think the country is ready to.
We don't need to be told every day for social distancing to wash our hands.
But after scenes like this over the weekend, police having to break up house parties and beaches around the country teeming with sun worshippers, the prospect of seeing strangers en masse again can be nerve-wracking.
Yesterday down here it was busy and people were just acting like nothing had changed. That worried me a bit.
Being immunocompromised, I worry about going back to work.
Nervous that it will come back and we'll have to go back into lockdown again.
Hot off the presses, the government's rebuilding budget will be released Thursday, the same day we take our massive leap into level 2.
But there are risks ahead, so please be vigilant at level 2. Irresponsible behaviour will take us backwards.
And no one wants that.
Tova, it's quite a different look, level 2, than what was laid out last week. Why is that?
Sam, parts of level 2 were simply deemed too risky. That was the advice from Ashley Bloomfield to the Prime Minister and Cabinet, and they agreed. And the PM also pointed to other advice from scientists that there's still a chance of silent spread, that case numbers could yet take off. So that outlining that she did last week of mass gatherings up to 100 people has now been capped at 10. That number will be reassessed in a couple of weeks and then reassessed in another couple of weeks. And if our case numbers stay low, our bubbles can grow. The other thing that phasing of level 2 suggests is that we could be there for a while, that it's a graduated level that we should all get used to incrementally, but get used to nonetheless.